All praises to the Almighty, Sublime, Majestic, Creator of all things, our loving kindness. Hallelujah. And to all of my fellow servants in this world and beyond, I send you infinite love and light, and I receive yours. Yeah, I visited this place. This is going to be a short one. I did two parts to this video, but somehow the last part of it erased. We have plenty of time. There's so much going on in this beautiful area. Yeah, if you're new to my station, we're on Google Earth Africa, where anomalies are being unveiled. The anomaly is Eden being uncovered. It's very magical, and this is one of the areas that I wanted to visit this morning. It's on the Cape of Uriel, you guys. So if you follow my station, we're going to go. I might add another little end part so I can explain the Cape of Uriel to newcomers, okay? But we're just going to move around and look around in this area and see what we find. You know, I just talk through it. Sometimes I mention things that I see, and a lot of times I don't mention things that I see. And hopefully you'll see even more. You'll see even more. It's a lot going on here. Yeah. So if I mention something and you just don't see it, don't worry about it. I'm not trying to convince you. I'm just keeping a record of all of the beautiful things that I'm seeing. Like these creatures right here. You see their little brown faces? Yeah, it's a lot of creatures in Eden that we knew nothing about. And this is a spiritual realm. It's not a 3D world like ours. It's very spiritual. It's a 5D world. We're just getting peeks into it as it's being unveiled. So it's much different from our reality. Yeah, it almost looks sci-fi. It almost looks sci-fi, but it is not. It is real. You see the coordinates on the bottom of your screen. Yeah, this is real. It doesn't look like Earth because it's another dimension from inside of Earth where Eden was taken. Eden was taken inside of Earth and covered with sand. And we can see here where the Sahara sands again are blowing away. And underneath that sand is all kind of magic. The magical land of Eden. And so there's a residual there of that sand. But this was what was underneath all of those sand dunes. Yeah, been blown away since the fall of mankind and never returning. Yeah. And so now we're at the bottom of it. The Most High uses Sahara sands like an hourglass, and we're at the bottom of it now. Yeah. Because it's time for Eden to be unveiled, because the Most High promised Adam and his descendants that they would return to Eden. Yeah. So it's like it's a transition going now as this 3D matrix is getting phased out. I hope you know. Yeah, the 3D is getting phased out. And this 5D dimension, along with a lot of other things that are going to be happening besides Eden, that's just my focus. But the whole world is going to change into the 5D. And that's why the Most High is elevating us. Yeah, he's elevating us. First, he started with all of these truths that were hidden from us. Yeah, a lot of truths hidden from us, and our brothers are doing such a wonderful job of researching and giving us this information. I appreciate your work so much. My job is quite different because these things are not written. It was not written in the books. How New Earth was going to start appearing on this earth, it just wasn't written. It told us about a lot of things, you know, hints about Eden. Not a whole lot of information about Eden. Yeah. It's like clues for this day. So when the unveiling happens, we'll be able to recognize. But the Most High didn't leave a treasure map to Eden. Just hints. Just hints. Okay, so we're gonna back it up out of here so I can show you the Cape of Uriel. Okay, this is right by that area. I was trying to find the exact spot, but I ran across this area to continue on. Before we go to Uriel's Cape, I also wanted to talk about the technology, because you can see that those fiber optics are underneath here as well. The fiber optics, yeah. So the technology, that's what this cloaking device is about. Yeah. So look at this heel though. Look at this magical heel. Wow, it's so beautiful. That looked like red flowers, I don't know, and blue. Wow. Uh-oh. Wait a minute here. Let's see if we could see some faces. We're just gonna look around a little bit. It's still quite blurry here. Yeah, but those are heads, yeah, and different creatures and such. You can see their shapes on this magical, very magical heel. Ooh, wow, look at this, you guys. I thought I was gonna make a short one, but ooh, wee, look at this. Oh, kind of magic going on right here. Wow. This looks like a little host of angels right here. Or it could be Atlanteans. I don't know. It's like they're going down into the water. I don't know, but I know that the black spots are their heads. And some of them look like black and white pictures, but those are heads with the light garments on, the white garments. Wow, it's all kind. Those probably are Atlanteans too. Shalom, all you fellow servants over there in Eden. I like to acknowledge them. Yes, they are real, honey. These are living creatures. And it looks like it's not real, but it is. Yeah, this is very real. Those coordinates are on the bottom of your screen. This is not sci-fi. It's just we look into another dimension and it looks strange. Very strange indeed. Look at that. Can you imagine running across something like this in the desert? Ooh, look like I see something down here. Whoa. Ooh, wee. Wow, it's a lot of heels. Did I look at this one yet? So it couldn't be water. Well, it could be water with a barrier holding it in. I don't know. I don't know if it's water or not, or just the lands look this color. How beautiful this is. And I see some spotting angels right up in here. Yeah, you can see their heads. Oh, wee. Wow. See? This one has a blue head. Here's some together right here. Shalom! And if you have children, you know, this would be so, it would just be such a good exercise for you to teach your children about this uncovering and let them see all the magic and let them see what they see. Because children, their minds are so much more pure. I bet they would pick up on all kind of stuff, you know, for your homeschooling projects. Very magical. And maybe they can paint some of these places. I know my sister, she's an artist, and she does the acrylic pour paints, And she has painted things that were very similar to the things that I'm showing you. So before I even showed her the place, like, she would show me one of her acrylic pours, and I would find a place with the same thing in it. Like, she was painting those little light creatures. She was painting those a lot. And she didn't even know why. It was just like little black heads with the light body streaks on her paintings. Yeah. And I would say, girl, this is over there in Eden. Oh, look at that one. Looks like it has long black hair. Some more back here. Whoa, this is an angel dwelling. This is an angel dwelling. And I'm sure that there's some Atlanteans here too, because I don't see a whole lot of wings. Shalom, peace and love, peace and love. And I would love to come to your worlds. They're so beautiful. So we have a lot of them going on here. This is like another city. Whoa, they're standing like in a circle. How majestic. All I can say is, Yahweh, you are just so phenomenal. I mean, beyond our imagination, your works and your creation and your imagination. This is so wonderful. Hallelujah. Okay, you guys, so there's a cloaking device again. Now I'm going to back away to Uriel's garment. Here's two buttons right here. Here's two buttons on his cape, okay, which is the garment he wears. And here's another button on his collar. It looks like a button. Looks like a button with some kind of frilly stuff around it. His side profile. Yeah, this is Sir Uriel. Yeah, it was a sad day when mankind fell. Yeah, and had to come into this 3D matrix. Even the archangel shed a tear. And he has his fiery sword. And here's his right wing spanning up and over. His right wing is going over the Red Sea all the way down to his feet. Is detailed. Because this is a spiritual manifestation from the 5D. Okay? Okay, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and all your encouraging comments. I love you guys. I send everybody infinite love and light. Hebrew Widow out.